everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do Ice Queen nails because goddamn is it cold outside. It's not snowing yet though. I don't think we'll get snow till February, I don't
know. I hope not. Snowed the other night. Cars rear-wheel drive, so I'll have
it was
to park
snowing
up
in Kidsgrove on Saturday night.
I'll have to park up the lane.
It was snowing up Kidsgrove?
Yeah.
Get.
It was when we were
driving. Yesterday.
Yeah. Get.
Yeah, it was.
Really?
Big, massive flakes, yeah.
How big? She's just gone like massive flakes.
Covered the windy.
Yeah. Oh my God.
No, they were massive. Yeah, honestly, it just didn't stick. Should have been another degree.
I do like snow.
I do as long as I don't have to go out.
Because I do like icicles. I don't know if I've told them this before about the pony that lived at the back of me.
Yes, I remember that story, yeah.
The pony that lived at the back of me in Patmore, one year had icicles all hanging off it.
Yeah.
The most beautiful icicles, but we felt sorry. And we actually fed the horse some, like, soup.
To try and
warm the poor thing up. He wipes it down in a stable.
Yeah, well, they
and we had bad winters then. Up Patmore, we had bad winters.
Oh, is this when the snow drifts were 20 feet high?
They were 20 feet high.
The top of the lamppost.
We had to dig the old ladies out in the street.
Honest.
I need to get photos because I don't think anybody believes me. Somebody
put some photos on from Stoke-on-Trent, but it was in the 60s.
The thing is, though, it is very up and down here. So I suppose everything that's at the top flows downhill.
Yeah.
So if you're in the bottom of a thing, you might.
Oh, but it used to be really.
Really bad.
Yeah,
I mean, it was
bad
that time when we got stuck and we went to the pub.
That wasn't that bad.
It was bad, but it wasn't. It was drifting, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was horizontal.
Yeah.
The snow was coming down like that.
But when we were kids, it was really bad.
Oh, it was bad.
Really bad. The school was closed all the time.
All the time. It's such a shame. Anyway, enough about us. Let's crack on with these nails. So we're going to do these icy nails. It's going to be a different way of creating that sort of shattered, icy kind of nail. Doing it a little bit different than we've done before, because we have done icy nails before, but I'm going to do it a little bit different because this way might be easier for you or for, you know, might not. Who knows? I'm going to start off by... shall I just... I've already prepped the nail, removed surface shine and all that because we've soaked off Andrea's nails. She had Sammy the Snake on there. We've soaked them off. We have a video all about that.
Just a quick one. Obviously, I know you're doing ice nails, but what are you going to do as in, like, is there different things you're doing on here? I'm just working
out. It's going to be a full set that's all a little bit different.
Right, okay.
There'll be... two nails that will be icy, like shattered icicle nails. Mm. The other ones are going to have loads of glitter and stuff like that, yeah?
Sorry, I wasn't looking right. I got a message there.
I was going to say.
Sorry.
Apple Watch. Everybody does that. It's got an Apple Watch. If you look at the watch and
you think, again,
how long?
Again, hurry up.
Yeah. Sorry, I just did get a message. It's so annoying.
That was like 10 seconds too long.
Sorry, Kirsty.
There's going to be different techniques within this full set.
Okay. We'll break it up into a couple, I think.
You can break it up into a couple, I suppose. Okay. But do you want me to do the ice ones first?
Well, I'll just literally cut it. You can do whatever you want.
All right, I'll just carry on and he'll do his magic.
Or Jay and Emma will do that.
Yeah, Jay will do his magic in the editing suite. So I'm going to put forms on. And we're going to do a ballerina shape. Oh, I wonder why, because I absolutely love it. And the reason I'm doing a ballerina is because I want more... surface. I was going to do stiletto, but I've done stiletto icy once before, so we do a different shape, and I want more surface to be able to see what's going on in the nail. I'm going to do an ice one here, and I'm going to do an ice one here, but I'm going to put all the forms on, and then Adam can just chop this video up into whatever he wants to chop it up to. Now, if you struggle with form placement, we have a few videos, just dedicated to fitting a form. Now, this one, I need to cut it a little bit because, see this? Big gap under the nail. Don't want that. Let me just size this up. So I'm just looking at where I'm going to cut this. And I'm going to cut it down there. Okay, pull it out. And here we go. Right, so I've got clear acrylic, crystal clear one. And we've got, oh, look at my hair. Intensile dock. Sorry. Medium speed liquid, because I want to have a little bit of time, but not too much. I'm going to do a clear base. Now, normally I would do the clear base as thin as a top coat, but for the index finger and the ring finger, I want it a little bit thicker. Those are going to be my ice nails. I'm going to pull this down. I want it a little bit thicker because I need to be able to remove the form. How long, Andrea? Three?
What do I normally have?
I haven't got a clue.
It's normally a three.
You would think I'd know by now. Is it a three? I know Faye's is like a four.
Yeah, no, not as long as Faye.
No, not as long as Faye, I don't think so.
Oh, no.
Ooh, no. I'm going to smooth this out. And then we're going to come in with natural beige. Feather that down. So it just comes onto the free edge a little bit. That can start setting up, and as that starts setting up, I can put my clear base on this one. This one doesn't need to be quite as thick. I'm going to add glitters to this nail. So it's all about planning what you're going to do. And don't get it wrong, some designs do kind of evolve as you do them. And I'm going to put a thin layer of clear on the natural nail. That'll be as thin as a top coat or like a base coat. This one we're going to do just like we've done that index finger. We build out that clear layer. Natural beige, I'm going to pull this one down at a little bit of an angle just to make it a little bit different and blend. Can I come back to this and just check? Yeah, we can pinch that now. Again, a little bit of clear on the nail bed. Pinching my next one, I'm gonna get out some beautifulness. Anything that sparkles, it's beautiful. So we have some little shapes, like a little star, like a pew star though, not a, it's a pew star, not a normal star.
A pew star.
Yeah. You know what I mean, don't you?
Do you know what things they're from or not?
They are from. So this one is from the multicolored triangles set. We've got many, many, many colors. And then the stars are from this set. Ignore those two. I've put those two in there. They are called this. I think. If it's not, I'm sure Adam will link it below. Then from this one, which is the iridescent shapes, we've got like these shards of mylar. Very random. They're not a perfect shape. They're all very, very random. I've got some chunky silver glitter. Then I've got a fine silver glitter. I'm going to get them all out. And I'm going to open all the bloody lids.
Oh, good.
Then I have got some blue. This is Twilight Blue. It's the mini glitter. Oh, they've got already getting it. Yeah, and then we've got this one as well. It's like a silvery blue, this. So quite a lot. Kirsty, do not make a mess. So on this one here, I am going to pick up a bead of clear. I'm going to get some of my glitter. Just like that. I'm going to place that on. We don't want it to be solid, we want it to work out quite transparent. Just adding in a little bit of bling. Get a sparkle. Because every ice queen needs a little bit of sparkle. I'm going to take a bead of clear, quite wet. Pop that on. Then I'm going to pick up a star. Place that on. Press it in. How pretty is that already? I'm like, oh, I love it, I love it. On this one, here we've worked at that angle. Bead of clear into the glitters. I'm literally just touching the top surface so it just picks that up. We're going to give it a whoosh around like that. And we're going to bring it down at that angle. And again, you don't want it solid. You want it quite sporadic. Is that the right word?
Yes. Sporadic is the right word, yeah.
Sporadic.
Or sparse.
Sparse, yeah. I like sporadic. And I'm going to put another little star in here. So again, I'm going to put two, actually. I'm going to put one here. And I'm going to put one here. Let's pick up the stars. Press that in. Another star. On this and this, we are going to put a whole load of glitter. I'm going to work with my silver first. I'm going to whoosh it round, mixing it together. So we already put a clear, thin layer onto the natural nail first. This was so everything sticks really well. So you've got great adhesion. I'm going to pull that down. Smidge more. I'm going to put that star in there, and we'll have some of the triangle shapes as well. Just so we've got different textures and dimensions throughout the nail. Even though it's all silver and glittery. Then I'm going to work with the blues. These to be a little bit more transparent because it gives it more of an icy effect. So move that around and blend that up so they kind of overlap a little bit. You want these sparse areas. And then we are going to put a little bit of mylar. Shards of mylar in there as well. They look amazing when the light catches them. I'm going to reverse the direction of the glitter on this one, so I'm going to work with the blue at the top. Thank you. when I look at them now, I think, oh, I just want to put a touch of mylar in here and here. So I am just going to wet that with a little bit of clear acrylic, and I'm just going to add, you know, I've seen how it kind of evolves. The design is evolving as we go. That's too big of a piece, we don't want that. So you don't want it to take over the design, you want it to add just a little bit of pizzazz. Now I know that these are stable enough, I'm going to do the thumb. Clear base again. So I'm going to take the forms off, now we're all set. Then I'm going to get into my normal filing routine. Then we'll do the ice. I'm going to file up the side walls, get them nice and straight. I'm going to file around the cuticle area, get that nice and neat. And then I can come and do this free edge. And then I love to just file the sides like this, nice and straight. The file is straight, it's not bent. Gets everything straight, and then I can contour the surface. I'm going to buff the nails over, make them nice and smooth. Notice how I just kicked Andrea's hands underneath my hand. If your client is like this, you are. And you're buffing, you've got far more chance of hitting that nail. So you want to do this. So your hand is in front of their fingers. What I'm going to do now is, on the underside of these two, I'm just going to take a file and just abrase it a little bit. It doesn't need to be fully abrased. So I'm just twisting a file through there. Lint-free wipe with some gel residue wipe-off solution. Give that a good clean. Notice it was only a 240 grit file that I used. And then I'm going to use some packaging. This is actually from the couch roll or desk roll, whatever you want to call it. That was once upon a time in there. This is the perfect thing to use. So I've got some of that, and you can just tear a piece off. I have screwed up a piece already, just like that. So it's all wrinkly, like my face.
And I've got no wrinkles.
Oh, I have a little help. just a little bit. I'm going to use the builder in a bottle. Clear as day. And we're going to paint that on the inside of the nail. I'm going to rub my finger across the top. There. And we're going to take the wrinkly paper. Actually, I'm going to use this top part, that'll be easy. Press in. And I want you to do a little... Sorry, I'll just say that again, I'm talking to myself. I want to be able to just move this around a little bit just to enhance those wrinkles. This is going to give you your icy effect. Once you're happy with how the plastic is sitting in the gel, we can pop that in the lamp. She says it's got a bottom on it. This is the worst lamp for us. And we're going to peel that off. Can you see all the wrinkly business? We're going to clean that over with some gel residue wipe-off solution. And we're going to file the underside like this so we get rid of those excess bits. Let's dust that and then let's give that another clean. Can you see when the top coat goes on, if we just wet that, we've got that icy nail. Oh, I'm excited, can't wait top coat. Right, we're going to do the same with this one. Going to put a little bit, so you've got a little bit of top coat there, yeah, we're not going to fill it. All we're going to do is brush along, because you don't want to sort of fill in those recesses, you just want to add a little bit of shine underneath. So you haven't got, we haven't got a lot of top coat on there. So put it in the lamp that way. So now it's bling time, obviously. So we're going to put on, now this says crystal flower cluster, but I think this looks like a snowflake, so we're going to use this. We're going to put it on with a little bit of acrylic first, and then we're going to add some aqua gel for the other stones. I like to put my big massive pieces on with acrylic. So you'll need just clear acrylic. I'm going to pop that bead there. Pick up my little charm. Press it in. And then you just want to use your brush to get rid of the excess. I'm going to finish with some cuticle oil. Now we've got stones on. For the Ice Queen. Andrea the Ice Queen.
Yeah. I like that.
I think that sounds good.
I think that's good.
Makes you sound cold, and you're certainly not a cold person, though.
No.
She's not a cold person. Yeah, so we've got the ice here. I think it looks dead cool. Look at that.
Beautiful.
That is so cool. Beautiful Icy Queen nails. Perfect for this time of year.
Definitely.
Definitely. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget, everything that I've used will be listed below in case you've missed anything. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Now a fire.
Hang on, man. Bloody hell, impatient.
Shift your phone, please. Fuck my phone.
And then just come upstairs to touch. Do you want to pull the thing?
Push on. Yeah, there we are. And there. I'm just going to buff now.